What's up guys, what's going on? My name is Hiroshi from webstarpress.com. Welcome to another video. If this is your first time here, I can boost up your design and software engineering skills by sharing tools and my coding experience. So if you want to learn and grow in this area, join this channel by hitting subscribe button and bell icon. Doing small stuff with React.js is very easy. Small things such as changing state and elements on the screen is a breeze. In this video, I will show you how can you change the text of a button by clicking it. By using React.js, if you want to change or toggle a text of a button by clicking it, one way is to set the state for this button. Clicking on it will toggle the state on or off, and you can change text based on the state. In React.js, we use state a lot. State is like a temporary memory for holding small pieces of information that can be used across your application whenever you need it. Here is how. This is a basic React.js project. Let's start by changing the default page. And this is the default page that React.js boilerplate gives us. And let's start by changing the default page and adding a button to it, and then we will add state for the button to change text in the button. We do not need this header. Instead, we need a button here. So this is our button. Let's style this button. This is our app.css, and let's give it a nice style. Padding some background color, some border radius. Save it, and this is our button. Maybe a little bit margin from top, and let's increase font size. Let's save our button. So here you are, this is our button, and I want to click on it and change the text inside it. So if this is on, when I will click add this button, it will display the text off, and when it will be off, and I will click at it, and it will show the text back to on. To trigger that functionality, I need some kind of event handling, and I need some kind of trigger, and that is on click. And as you can see here in HTML, we use this on click event handler like this, but in React.js, we use capital letter C in camel case on click, and then a function name inside brackets. So let's do this. On click inside the bracket, here is my function, this dot click handler, or let's change the name to handle click. This name can be anything. So this is my function. Let me come back to my page and let's save it. And if I click at it, nothing happens. Now I will have to add functionality to it. So I will place this click handler here, and this is my function. When I will click add this button, this function will be called, and inside this function, when I click add the button, I want the state to change. But for that, I need to add the state to this component first. So let's add the state constructor props super props, and this is our state, this dot state. We declare the state like this, and then I will add an identifier inside it, is toggle on true. This is a boolean value. It can be false, it can be true. We will turn this to false and true, and when it will be true, we want to display on here. And when it will be false, we want to display off here at the button. So our state is done, and let's add functionality to this click handler. Alright, so I will click at this button, and this click handler will be triggered on click, and here are the instructions to change the state. And essentially I will do it like this: if the state is false, it will be true, and if it is true, it will be false. So this dot set state is toggle on. I will refer to my reference in this state, and here will be state dot is toggle on, but I will use not operator here. And what is the not operator? It is a logical operator that says returns false if its single operand can be converted to true, otherwise it returns true. I will use this logical not operator. All right, so it says that this dot set state, that is toggle on. You can use any other name instead of is toggle on, it's up to you, totally up to you. And its value is a boolean value, that is false, and if it is false, then turn it into true. And if it is true, then turn it into false. Simple. Okay, by clicking at the button, we encounter an error. That is because we did not bind this click handler. We have to bind this. We have to bind each event handler in the constructor area here. So this dot handle click, this is my function. I am binding this function is equal to this dot handle click dot bind this. Let's save it and press the button again. Now the state is changing. Let me show you where. If I go to components for this page, and let me go to the component again at this section, and when I click this button, you can see that it is showing the state is changing here. Is toggle on, true, false, it is changing. So all I have to do is to display in my page. So let's do that. So how can we display this state or use this state in the page? We can display it like this, this dot state dot our identifier name. Let me add a break after the button and let's save it. And we still don't see anything here. Why? Well, because we have to use a tag and enclose this text inside that tag. Still nothing. That's strange. So it turns out that it is a boolean value. It won't be displayed. We will have to use some kind of check or expression to check whether the value in our state is false or true, and then based upon that value we can select to display something at the page. So let's try it out. So this is the check. This statement right here contains our state value, but it is not displaying. So we will use a ternary expression here. Let's save this page, and here is the value. And as you can see, when I click on this button, the value changes. Let's move this expression inside this button. Instead of this static text on, we can use this expression inside the button. Let's save it and let's check how it's like. So it is toggling, it is turning on and off. So what did I do here? So these brackets right here, this is React.js, and you are looking at the tags here such as div and button, and you can use here paragraph, but you are writing JSX here, you are writing JavaScript here. If you want to display something here, you will have to use the tags and something inside those tags. But if you want to show some kind of result or something, then you will use these kinds of brackets, and it will, and you can use JavaScript or expressions inside this these brackets. So that's what this is. And this is this right here, question mark, and this sign is it is a condition. It is simple if else condition, expression if true or expression if false. If this condition is true, if it will find the value true here, it will display the value right after the question mark. And if the value is false here, it will display this value. This is if this is true, then show this one. Or if it is false, then show this one. Simple. And you can display this thing as many times as you like in this component, and it will display without any problem. Another br this one and this one, and another one. Save, and here are the values, and these are all changing. You can display this button, this text inside the button, or you can display this changing text or toggle activity outside of this button. It is all right. So we do not need this. Okay, pretty simple, right? So we used a button and we applied on click event handler at the button, and then we used a function to apply our logic to this, and inside our function we instructed this application to set the state to true if it is false and false if it is true, and this is our state declaration. Our identifier was this, and this is a boolean value. Remember, this is a boolean. This is not like this. This is not a string. This is a boolean value. It will be false or it will be true, and we are turning it false if it is true and true if it is false. All right, and then we are displaying it by using this expression, this simple expression here, if else expression, short form of if else expression, if you will. And this is our check that if the value in the state is true, then show on text on. This is simple string. This can be anything. This can be anything, and as you can see here, right? Or in other case, if it is false, then show the off. And this is our simple page with a single button that toggles some text at it. And another thing, if you do not want to bind this function, this click this function, you will have to bind each function that you will create. If you don't want to do that, then there is another way to do that. You can just use arrow function and it will work fine. See, it is working. But if you don't use that arrow function and don't bind this function, then it won't work. On click, you will get an error. You will have to bind this to make it work, or you will have to use this arrow function. Pretty simple, right? So it is very easy to toggle things on off or changing the state by using that state thing in the React.js. Do you use React.js? Let us know if you want similar tutorials. I hope you liked the video. If I missed anything or you have something to add to this, you can comment down below. Ask questions related to this topic. If you haven't already subscribed, subscribe to the channel and hit bell icon to receive channel updates. Join us on social media. Links are in the description below. Stay tuned for coming updates, and I will see you in the next video.